the game of Celebrity Gossip, Tattletales. And now, here's the star of Tattletales, Bert. Everybody, thank you. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to have you. We have a hot group. No, I can hear you back there. I love it when the group is hot. There's nothing better than that. We got a hot group back here, and you're going to meet them, too. Right now, from Happy Days, Mr. Anson Williams and Laurie Mahaffey. Winning money for the banana section today, appropriately enough, Mr. Steve Allen and Jane Meadows. Winning money for the red section today, Christopher Joy and Deniece Williams. Yay! You know that's true, Steve, and I know, and I've certainly, Anson, you know from working in front of live audiences all those years on the show, that you can feel audiences are all different.
Yes.
Every single time, and yes. This one, before I even got out here, I could hear them yelling and screaming for you guys. I knew it was going to be
wild,
which means they can also turn vicious real quick.
Animal spirits.
Yes, it's all right there. They're waiting to see which way it's going to go, you know. Okay, here we go. This first question, we're going to start things rolling right away, then we'll visit as we go along. Okay. Mm-hmm. The first question is for the ladies, as you know, worth $150 to your respective rooting sections, and this is the way it goes. Ladies, if the two of you ever decide to take a second honeymoon, will you go to the same place you had your first honeymoon, or will you go someplace else? Logical question. Ladies, go away and think about it. Anson, what will Laurie say to this? Steve is chuckling already.
Well, personally, I'd like to go to Palmdale, but...
You would, eh?
No. No, she's a romantic. Laurie's very, very romantic, and she'd want to go to the same places where we went on our first honeymoon.
Where did you go on your first honeymoon?
Well, San Ysidro Ranch, and then... No, in Santa Barbara. It's gorgeous. It's neat. Yes. Yeah. We got married there, stayed there a few days, and we went to Carmel, you know, Big Sur, San Francisco.
Oh, what's wrong with that?
Nothing. But I like Palmdale.
Yeah. Okay. I'm not going to pursue that. What happened to you in Palmdale, Anson?
None of your business.
None of my business. Thank you. They're doing that to me a lot lately. Did you notice that?
But whatever it was, he had to go to San Ysidro to get rid of it.
And couldn't get an answer there. Had to go to Monterey and Carmel for a second and third opinion. All right. You'll say, Laurie will say, the same place.
Yes.
Here she comes. Where are you going to go? What are you going to do for the second honeymoon, Laurie?
Well, if it's up to me, that wasn't really clear to me, but if it's my decision, Anson didn't plan too well for the last one. Mm-hmm. He didn't make any reservations. It was Thanksgiving week. We spent the last night of our honeymoon at a hotel over a gas station.
Uh-huh.
So it'd be a little different this time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, that's not what he said. Isn't that funny? You notice
Laurie.
How the stories come out totally different.
Laurie?
What?
What? What about all the romantic places up the coast, you know? All the way up to San Francisco?
Romantic places? We took the last room they had anywhere we went.
Once over a gas station, once under a gas station.
One was again.
You walk 10 blocks, you hit the ocean, Laura. I mean,
it's only 2 blocks to the ocean.
It makes me mad just thinking about it again. I'm not speaking to you.
I'm sorry. There may not be a second
Laura,
honeymoon, you know?
Be romantic, you know.
Please, don't fight, kids.
I'm
you got it fighting. Wrong. It's the way it is. I'm sorry.
Your fault, Laura.
Steve, what will Jane say to this one?
This poses an interesting dilemma for all you dilemma posers out there. Jane and I never really had an official honeymoon, you know, where you get silk pajamas and you go to Cleveland or something.
Yeah.
We were both so busy that we just went right back to work.
Right.
But if we had a honeymoon, I think Jane would want to go back to the same place, so I give you that answer.
Wait a minute. If you had a honeymoon, which you didn't have, she'd like to go back to the same place.
Yeah.
Which is nowhere at this point.
I rest my case.
Step down.
You gave us an A or B choice. I mean, if we had a honeymoon, she would have had to go back to the same had place.
I'm not going to panic here. I'm going to be very calm.
No,
you see, what you could do, however, Jane is liable to say, we never had a honeymoon, so how can I make a choice? So I'll just have to say...
Well, she might say the same kind of a thing. If we ever did, I would have liked to go there. Or no, I would like to go to a different place each time.
Yeah.
Or if she has a honeymoon with some other guy sometime. could work any million ways.
Well, this could go. You could also say, we didn't go any place, so how can I make a choice? That would match her. She may say, we didn't have one. I mean, if you have to do that, see, I don't want to confuse the issue.
You have.
Here. I'm sorry. Let's say that she'll say, if you had had one, you would go back to the same place.
I'll stand on my constitutional rights.
Okay. Here she comes. Jane, we need an answer from you. What are you going to do on your second honeymoon?
Well, I hope we're going to do something. We never had a honeymoon the first time.
Yeah?
And did Steve tell you about What's My Line?
No.
We were married on a Saturday, and on Sunday he was a panelist of What's My Line, and I was the mystery guest, and he didn't guess me.
Oh!
As a matter of fact, I was doing a high voice, and he said, I don't know who you are, but you sound like Minnie Mouse.
Oh!
So I hope you'll take me anywhere. I'll settle for anything.
Well, but we need an answer. He has given us a choice. So what we want to know from you, will you go the same place or someplace else?
Someplace else?
No.
Oh, you mean I have to say where we would go?
No.
Game is over.
But what happened? It was almost an impossible answer for you you didn't go someplace.
We didn't go anywhere.
Well, he said if you did go someplace, had you gone to someplace,
I would have gone back there.
That's what he said.
Oh, sure. Sure, I would have gone back there. Don't worry. Yeah.
I submit, Your Honor, that the witness is being deliberately evasive.
Now, that's good game playing. Oh, yes, I would have done that. I'm sorry, nobody's gotten this right, so it's not
But I got it right.
No, but only on the fourth try. It doesn't really...
Oh, I see.
It doesn't really count. It was hard. It was impossible for you. Christopher, you can get the whole thing right off the bat here for the red section.
All right.
Do you think?
Well,
tell us about your honeymoon,
I know that Deniece would want to go back to the same place. We were up in Carmel and Monterey on our honeymoon. And we had a great time.
Yeah.
We only had a few days because we were both working.
As a matter of fact, they had your room, Anson.
that's the one.
Oh, you went to Palm Deal too.
Yeah. In fact, nowhere is not a bad place to go. But no, I think she would say go back to the same place
we
want to go back there.
Okay, here she comes. Deniece, you can get the whole thing here. I almost said you can get the whole thing for the nephew, but I didn't do that. Because you know your name is spelled like niece, isn't it?
I know. My mother wanted to be unique. What can I tell you?
No. I think it's terrific. Now, the answer we're looking for you is either you will go to the same place or someplace else.
Well, our honeymoon was so special. It was a little hideaway that I had, in passing, said to Christopher I'd like to go. And he took me, and we had such a wonderful time. I'd say... I'd go back to the same place.
That's the one. You got it. You got it all for the red section, too. And we'll come back in a moment with question number two. Don't miss it. Got a good group today. See you in a minute.
Hey! I believe when you got a problem, you just got to roll with it. So I took control with Depend Refastenable Underwear. It's new. It's like regular underwear. No more big, bulky things. Happy day. Plus, it's refastenable, so it's easy to change. Now all I worry about is keeping up with the styles. Take control with Depend. Gorgeous.
Are you tired of shaving your legs every day? Are you tired of painful pulling, plucking, and irritating creams? Then you need the OnLiv Hair Removal System, an amazing breakthrough that not only removes unwanted hair without any pain, but actually helps keep it from growing back. Look, products like wax, sugar, and nads pull your hair. Ouch! Razors cut hair above the root. It grows back faster and thicker. But OnLiv is a natural lotion enriched with vitamin E that removes the whole hair, including the root, without any pain. While it's amazing, Hair Inhibitor Gel slows down hair regrowth and helps keep it from growing back. You'll never have to shave or wax again. And unlike painful wax or nads, OnLiv even removes short hair. Even tough body hair is no problem for OnLiv. Days later, the side that used OnLiv is still smooth. Amazing! In fact, we put it to the ultimate test against sugar, waxing, and shaving and nads. And look, OnLiv is faster, easier, and more effective than any of these products.
I used OnLiv 2 months ago, and my legs are still smooth. I didn't even have to shave on my vacation.
My girlfriend used to complain about the hair on my back. But now that I use OnLiv,
There's no pain, and it's gone for months.
Use anywhere in your body. At last, you can have the beautiful bikini line without irritation. No ingrown hairs. Electrolysis is expensive. Don't waste money on products that don't have a hair inhibitor. Only the OnLev hair removal system comes with a hair inhibitor gel, so you'll never have to worry about unwanted hair again. But wait, call within the next 10 minutes and we'll send you facial hair off. Remove embarrassing hair from your lip, eyebrows, and face for weeks. That's a $20 value free. We guarantee OnLev is the easiest way to remove unwanted hair or your money back, but keep the facial hair off just for ordering. Not available in stores, so don't delay. Order OnLev hair removal today.
To order, have your credit card ready and call this number or send your check or money order to the address on your screen. OnLev is only $19.99 plus shipping and handling and comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Call now.
Look, look, quick, quick, quick. Hello. Hi, we're back. Question number two coming your way in just a moment. And if you're ready, ladies, it is for you. You got to play catch-up to Deniece. She's got all the money. Ladies, you're going to a dressy party. How many outfits will you try on before you decide on one? Will it be just one, two, or more than that? Good, good question. Off you go. And Steve, we're going to start with you.
This is the only time of the many times I've been in this program that I have ever been absolutely confident that I knew the answer, and if Jane doesn't agree with me, I'll kill her. Because in her case, God love her, it's always three or more.
Really?
Yep.
Yeah. She doesn't make up her mind quickly. Does she ask you for your advice?
Yes, she does.
And what do you say?
I ask her for advice about my clothes, too.
Yeah. But, I mean, supposing she put on the second dress or the third dress and you're late.
Believe it or not, I happen to have good taste in women's clothing.
Oh, so I believe that. I've seen you a number of... Oh, I'm sorry.
I taught Milton Berle everything he knows. No, but I go with this answer.
Okay, you'll say, what was our answer? More than that is what it was.
More than that,
here she comes. Jane, we're looking for a choice here. What are you going to do?
Well... this is one of my big problems in life. I always have to ask Steve. I line up. We have these things in our, our doorways that the kids used to chin themselves on. And I hang dozens of dresses up there.
Yes.
And then I go down the line and I say to Steve, do you think I should wear this one? And he says, beautiful, anything. And I say, no, I don't think I'll wear that one. And I just keep going because... I don't know why. It's just one of my big problems in life.
So?
I don't always try on more than that. One, two. But I think I do try on more than two very often.
So your answer is more than that, and you're correct. That's what he said. Absolutely right. The reason I was trying to lead Steve a little bit, I said, when you're on your second or third dress and Jane says, how does this look? And sometimes you're not even looking. You're combing your hair. You say, great. Oh, it looks great, honey. Let's, you're
that's
late.
That's what he does.
I think all husbands have been guilty of that.
Really?
I think so, yeah.
Yes.
Because women always will ask you, how does it look? And you don't know. It depends on what you want to wear, They all look good.
Yeah, but when you ask us, we give you our undivided attention.
That's because we have white socks on with brown pants and black shoes, You can't do that, dummy. Christopher, what will Deniece say?
The question is, try on more?
Will she, before she decides which one to wear to this dressy party, will she try on just one, two, or more than that?
She looks at a lot. Try on, I actually put on probably more than two.
So it'd be more than that?
Yeah, more than two.
More than that.
Yeah, she'll go through this outfit.
She has gowns that she works in, too. I mean, she must have all kinds of stuff.
But that's a different closet.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, what am I saying?
It's a different thing.
Mercy.
Well, I mean, it's, like the glitter.
Yeah, right, the glitter closet.
When she goes out, when we're going out together, the glitter stays at home.
I see. You wear the glitter. Okay.
Right.
Here she goes. Deniece.
Yes.
We need a choice from you on... how many are do you try on more than one? How many do you try on?
This is a hard one. I didn't have this problem when I had a teeny weeny wardrobe, you see.
Yes.
But since it's...
Since you're a hit.
Since I'm a hit.
Things have changed.
I would say that I've been known to try at least two.
You'd say that?
I would say at least
two. Christopher said more than that.
What?
Welcome to Tattletales.
Not more than that.
Would you like to explain yourself?
Not more than that?
No, just You know, one or two, but...
I remember when you looked at two or three things, you tried on a couple, and then went out and bought something totally different.
That's true.
That's true. See, they straightened it out.
And that's
You're still
usually
wrong,
the way it is.
Yes, of course. Anson, what will Laurie say?
Could you repeat the question, please?
Yes, the question is, you're going to a dressy party. How many outfits will you try on before you decide on one?
Oh, I Just try one, on about two. Six. Oh.
Not you.
Not me.
One, two, or more than
she...
that.
Gosh, I hope she's honest. At least three.
At least three?
Yes.
So your answer is more than that?
Yes, more than two.
Really?
Yes.
So you can't make up her mind either, huh?
No.
Puts the pressure on you, does she?
Yes.
Sometimes?
A lot.
The answer is more than that. Here she comes. Laurie, we need a choice.
Well, it depends on whether I'm fat or not. If I'm fat that week, I have my, you know, I have to go through a couple.
Yeah.
And that's the majority of the time. So I would say two.
No, he said more than that. Which means Jane and Steve get the whole thing for the banana section. There you go. Step to the rear, gentlemen. It's halftime. We will bring the ladies out front, and we'll come back with the second half of Tattletales after this message for you. Don't go away.
He never wrote a book. He never held an office. He never did any of the things that usually accompany greatness. Yet all the kings that ever reigned and all the governments that ever sat have not had so much impact as that single solitary life. Now you can share the events of his remarkable ministry when you watch this free video, The Lamb of God. It's a gift from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. This powerful video depicts events from the life of Jesus Christ, as recorded in the King James Version of the Holy Bible. As you watch scenes of his birth, teaching, trial, death, and resurrection, you will better understand how his life can change yours. Call now for your free copy of The Lamb of God. It's a gift without cost or obligation from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
Did you know that the powerful heating medicine in Bengay increases blood flow at the site of application to help ease your aches and pains? Did you also know that Bengay's been scientifically proven to increase range of motion, decrease muscle and arthritis pain, and improve flexibility? And Ultra Strength Bengay has three powerful pain-relieving medicines, more than any other leading brand, and that adds up to fast, powerful pain relief. Ultra Strength Bengay, the power you want, the relief you need.
When you manage a restaurant all day, you need the strongest hold you can get. That's why I switched to Adhesius. Now I use Fixin' It Free. Oh, that's good. Now I can sip hot soup at lunch and still make it to dinner to greet my favorite customers.
Grandpa!
Even in the hottest liquids, when the other free adhesive stops holding, Fixin' It Free holds stronger and longer.
It's a long, hard day, but I love every minute of it.
For the strongest, longest hold, Fixin' It. And forget it.
Mrs. Brady, Mrs. Partridge, Mrs. Whammy. See your favorite moms on great game shows, plus a very special Mother's Day edition of Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck, featuring Dharma's mom, Laura Ingalls' mom, and George Costanza's mom. That's the mother of all game shows, Saturday, May 11th from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight Eastern and Pacific.
We're back. After halftime, and I have the ladies with me. The fellas are in the back. And gentlemen, you should know that we have two-thirds of a tie. Steve and Christopher are tied with $150 apiece. And Anson, you're going to get on the boards right now, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Here we go. This question is addressed to the fellas. It's worth $150 to your rooting sections. Men, your wonderful, efficient live-in housekeeper asks you if her boyfriend can sleep over in her bedroom whenever he wants to. Who is more likely to say yes? You, fellas, your wife, both of you, or neither of you?
Huh.
Okay? Oh. Once in all, if the boyfriend can sleep in her room whenever he wants to. Off you go. Good question. We'll start with Deniece. What do you think Christopher will say to that?
Boy, oh boy, out the door, probably.
Really? Oh, he wouldn't go for that.
I don't think I'd go for it.
Really?
No, I'd probably say, I think you better do it somewhere else. And I think he'd probably say,
No. Yeah, it would worry you. You think maybe it's, how long have you been married?
I think so. Not a year yet.
Well, that's probably why. I mean... After all,
newlyweds. No, we'll be married a year, July 3rd.
All right, so he will say.
Thank you.
He will say, both of you, or will he say himself? What will he say, do you think? Would rather, who is more likely to say yes? Neither of you, maybe.
Neither.
Okay. Is that what you mean? I see. I got to watch. I get this question
turned
really?
Around. Is it one of those kinds?
No, really. But it says, who is more likely to say yes? You just said you'd both disapprove, which means you both say no.
Yeah, we would both say no.
Who is more likely to say yes? So. Neither of you is the answer. I got it. Here he comes. You think it's easy, don't you? Figuring this out. Christopher.
Yeah.
What is your answer, sir?
Well, first of all, somebody has to point out to me who this efficient young live-in housekeeper is. I've never seen her in my place. But neither of us.
That's correct. Very well done, sir.
Yeah, I'm proud of you, honey.
Thank you, Christopher. Lori, what will Anson say?
There's no telling today.
That's true.
He's really off today. I think if he's really... He's not being honest. See, that's the problem. I apologize that we don't have
you
any points.
You mean Anson anyway. Williams is lying on network television?
It's not that he's lying. I think he's trying to second guess. He's forgetting that, you know, the other questions... This is his perspective, right? These questions. See, I understand how to do the game.
I see.
He doesn't.
I got it.
Okay, got that straight.
There'll be hell to pay at home tonight, won't there, gang?
I'd say neither of us.
Neither of you would approve. Mm-hmm. Here he comes. Anson, we are looking for approval or not.
Well, I think the key here is whenever he wants to. Mm-hmm. So I would say neither of us.
That's correct.
Goodness.
I thought we'd get a little more trouble with this one, but we didn't. Jane, what do you think Steve will say?
Well, I agree with Deniece. We both go to the same church, and we're very old-fashioned people, Steve and I. We wouldn't put up with any of that jazz. They would have to get married or, you know, go somewhere else.
Or ship out.
Yeah.
All right, the answer is neither of you.
Neither of us.
Here he comes. Yeah. Steve, we're looking for your approval or disapproval. What will happen here?
Well, I take a very dim view of that sort of thing. And I would say that Jane does too, and neither of us would.
That's correct. You got it. You all got it. We split that three ways. It wasn't very hard for you. But we'll get you with the next one, and we're going to do that right after this message for you with a $300 question. See you tomorrow.
Thank heavens, Classic Hollywood Squares has arrived tonight at 8:30 Eastern.
I cannot live another day without air conditioning.
Says tomorrow's gonna be hotter.
Hotter?
Like yesterday.
Yesterday? Yesterday you said you'd call Sears.
I'll call today.
You call now.
I'll call now.
Now's the time to save on Sears installed central air conditioning. Get a $300 mail-in rebate on select high-efficiency central cooling systems. Call for a free in-home estimate. Sears offers a choice of energy-efficient Kenmore and Trane systems that could save up to 20% on your annual cooling costs. In time, even pay for itself. Sears also offers fast emergency installation with all work done by a trained Sears cooling specialist and satisfaction guaranteed. Get a $300 mail-in rebate on select high-efficiency central cooling systems. Call and save with Sears.
So what's the paper say about tomorrow?
Another scorcher.
Cool.
Make fun of lunch. And now Lunchables lets you make fun of snack time, too, with Oreo and Chips Ahoy cookies.
That was nice. Okay, here we go. We're visiting a little bit quickly, but this one's got to go fast. $300, and this will decide the game. Close game, and even Anson can win. Men, it's for you. How much would you say... Now, listen to this. It's a good question. How much would you say the women's liberation movement has affected your life? A lot, a little, or not at all? How much would you say? Goodbye, guys. Good question. And we can talk about it for a long time. We're going to move it a little bit. What do you think Anson will say, Laurie?
A lot.
A lot?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Well, it's affected me, so therefore it affects him.
Really?
It better.
Has he adjusted to it? Does he like it?
I think he does. He didn't in the beginning, but he's a lot more supportive now.
Coming around.
Yeah.
So you'll say a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Here he comes. Anson, how much has it, in fact?
The women's liberation movement. Well, it's a lot of people running through the house, but I think Lori is always been liberated, so I would say not at all.
That's not what Laurie said, but you were very close.
Boy, am I gonna liberate him. Oh!
No, I just thought you,
sorry about
you were
that,
your
Anson.
Own individual, Lauren.
Laurie said a lot, a whole lot. Sorry
it's
about
really
that.
It's really a lot, Bert.
I'm sorry. Jane, what will Steve say?
Well, I think that Steve has always been very sympathetic to the women's movement. I think he will say a little. He would not say not at all. And I don't think you would have to say a lot.
But
I'm the one that's changed a lot.
Yes.
I'm a militant feminist.
Are you?
Militant.
Mercy.
Yes.
So beware.
But even with all that, he'll still say a little.
I think he'll say a little because, you know, I don't think he had to change a lot.
Yeah.
It would be nice if he said a lot. But it's what he will say. Oh, I mustn't talk too much. He'll say a little.
You have all the time in the world. He will say a little. Because it's a lot for you. Even with it being a lot for you, it's still only a little for him.
I think so.
See how quickly I picked that up?
Have to think what he's going to say, right?
Here he comes. All right, yes. Steve, we're getting down to it now. This will probably decide the game. What do you think?
Well, I support women's campaign for freedom and equality, and we've had Susan B. Anthony as a guest on our Meeting of Minds show. I would say it has affected my thinking and my life a lot.
No, that's not what Jane said, but it was close. She said a little. She said it affected hers a lot and yours a little. And she
because
was...
Because you already were kind to women, darling.
Yes, yes, darling,
that's
you forgot that.
That's why we did Susan B. Anthony and everything, but anyway, I'm proud he said a lot.
Yes, I am too.
I'm so proud.
The yellow section doesn't really care a heck of a lot. Deniece, what will Christopher say? This will decide the game.
Well, because he's really, I think my husband is old-fashioned and believes in the submissive woman and the this and the that, but he knew in marrying me that there's going to have to be some changes made.
Yeah.
And so I would say for him that it has meant a lot.
A lot.
I would say a
Here
lot.
Here he comes. Christopher, this will decide the game. How much has it meant to you, affected your life?
I would say it's only affected it a little.
No, that's not what Denise said. No one got that one right. So the game is up. Time is up. We have a tie. Jane and Steve and Denise and Christopher win it. Everybody missed that.
What did she say? No, not at all.
Like that. They didn't even come close, did they? We'll come back in a moment and split up the money. See you in a minute.
Oh, no. My ring.
Here's your ring.
Friend or Foe, starting June 3rd only on Game Show Network.
Super Cat here with new Arm & Hammer Crystal Blend.
The only one with baking soda, plus odor-trapping crystals. The advanced combination traps, absorbs, and prevents odors better than other scoopable litters.
New Arm & Hammer Crystal Blend, the superior odor fighter!
Attention respiratory patients. Are you on Medicare? Do you use an inhaler and still have problems breathing? Do you use albuterol, Combivent, or other respiratory medications? If so, you may qualify for premixed medications that are covered by Medicare. We will bill Medicare and your supplement insurance. There are no upfront costs to you, and we handle the paperwork. Your medications will be delivered directly to your door with no delivery fees. Call Star Medical toll-free at 1-800-530-0843.
Love chocolate? Try the new DQ Chocolate Extreme Blizzard Treat. Mixing cocoa fudge, chocolate chunks, and brownie pieces in soft serve. Got a thing for chocolate? DQ, something different.
Tired of juggling investments? Get the Orange CD from ING Direct. At 3.25% APY, it's the nation's highest yielding one-year CD with no minimum deposit or fees. And it's FDIC insured. Call 1-800-ING-DIRECT.
Check it out. All is fair in love and marriage on the Newlywed Game. Then bait your hooks and strap yourself to that seat for Card Sharks, followed by Family Feud.
Okay, we had a tie. Jane and Steve and Deniece and Christopher with $200 apiece. We had $1,000. They will divide $700 between those two sections. Very nicely done. Thank you all for being with us on Tattletales, Burt County, saying so long. I'll see you next time. Thank you.
In addition to cash awards, a member of the winning rooting section selected at random will also receive Hotter Than Books, More Than Romance, and Super Romance in the paperback world of worldwide romance. Ronco Clean Air, the anti-pollution machine that removes offensive odors and harmful pollutants from the indoor air you breathe from Ronco. A serving tray and Archway home-style cookies, over 30 delicious varieties baked from homemade recipes. Archway, the big cookie with a small town taste. And Volrath stainless steel kitchenware is the choice of many finer restaurants to prepare, cook, and serve food in your home. The value is Volrath. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Topman production.